Hello everyone, my name is Robert Hugh Morgan. I'm the University Organist at Stanford University, and I'm delighted to welcome you to this week's Sunday recital. This week I'd like to present a few works to you by a major composer from 20th century France, Maurice Durufle. Durufle was born in 1902 and began his musical career as a chorister in the Cathedral of Rouen. It was while singing at the cathedral that he developed his love of plain song, something that would last throughout his entire life and through his compositional career. At the age of 18, he began his studies at the Conservatory in Paris, studying organ with Eugène Gigou and composition with Paul Ducasse. He left the Conservatory having gained top prizes in organ and composition, among others. He became a close friend of the great blind organist Louis Vierne, and in 1927 became Vierne's assistant at Notre Dame. In 1929, he was appointed as organist of the Church of Saint-Étienne-du-Mont in Paris, and then also took up a position teaching harmony at the Conservatory in 1943. As I mentioned earlier, he had a deep, deep love for plain song. And so I'll begin and end this recital with two works based on plain song. To begin, the Prélude sur l'Entrée de l'Épiphanie. This short piece is based upon a piece of plain song for the Feast of the Epiphany. You'll hear the melody very clearly in the left hand. What's so beautiful about this piece is, I believe, gorgeously, almost austere harmonies which surround the melody, almost like clouds of incense. I'll follow this short work with his Scherzo, a very early piece in his output. Indeed, it's his first published organ work. This work has much of the influence of his first organ teacher in Paris, Charles Tournemire, with whom he studied before starting at the Conservatory. It's a wonderfully light piece with really quite delicate colours. The lightness of the opening pages also puts one in mind of certain works by Vierne, which is quite similar. The ending is amazingly effective. The music becomes just like a little flower that closes gently as the sun goes down.
Thank you.
Now we move on to one of his greatest works, the prelude, adagio, and variations on the plain song hymn, Veni Creator Spiritus, Come Holy Spirit. This is a large scale work, about 20, 25 minutes or so. But, and here's the amazing part, you don't hear the plain song melody in its entirety until about 6 minutes before the end. What he does in the prelude and in the adagio is to hint at the melody, sometimes letting fragments of it slip out, but never feeding it directly to us. The result of this is that when the plain song appears in its entirety, unadorned, it's like a great burst of light. You'll certainly hear it when it happens, trust me. The prelude inhabits the same sound world as that of the scherzo that you just heard. It's very fleet of foot, possessing very quick and delicate brush strokes. Also, it's very quiet all the way through. It's the art of incredibly skillful understatement. The adagio which follows is a strangely passionate work. It begins very quietly with, again, a hint of the plain song melody. It's a very gentle work, but towards the end, very quickly, starts to grow before it reaches a climax on full organ. And it subsides rapidly before we hear, as I mentioned earlier, the statement of the complete plain song melody. Four variations follow, the last of which is a vigorous toccata, bringing this great work to a triumphant conclusion. De Ruffler was a famously self-critical composer, never allowing works to be published until they were just right. As a result, his opus list only reaches 11 works. So I feel that it's really a privilege to hear and play any of his pieces. His fastidiousness as a composer may have resulted in very few published works, but my goodness, they are all wonderful. All of what you're hearing in these recitals are performances which are recorded in the church over the years, some of them at Sunday services, some of them at concerts. I do hope that you will enjoy this music from this master composer and craftsman. Thanks for listening. Be well, take care, and stay healthy.